So, hi, good morning, everyone. And we are going to start with a presentation regarding Transtats. So, thank you for joining and welcome. I'll start with this statement. Like, many of the Fedora software packages seem ineffective to cater native language users because of a lot of reasons. And one of the reasons is translation coverage. Whereas if you'll go and see translation statistics at platform, there is a different story. I mean, in platforms, translation statistics for few of the languages are too good. They are really very good. But they couldn't make to the build system and finally to packages. Why? So there is a gap in between. And we are working on a project to understand this gap. And the project is Transtats. And the project URL is transtats.org. So this is the development timeline. Basically, there are four important development stages. The first was to develop a service layer which can actually go and talk to various different services, maybe in two different translation platforms, build systems, different release schedules, and various different services. So we need to create a layer which can handle all those services and actually produce some standard results. Second was jobs framework. We have a concept of jobs in Transtats. These jobs collect data and do analysis. So we needed some framework to handle all the jobs. And third was to deploy it in Fedora. So we had some development process for OpenShift compatibility and deployment and henceforth. The final one which we did was to get over to Patternfly UI, and that was the final development stage before 0.75. 0.75 is the current release. Now let's look at the software package localization cycle. Here we can see that we have an array of translation platforms to choose from. First is Damlize, Sputel, Transfix, Weblet, Zenata, and there are so much. And suppose you have internationalized application and you need to translate that. So you need to extract and push everything to translation platform and then get that translated and push and merge back into the application. And then you are building that application and shipping it into various different channels in various different file formats. So here you can see that there are so many file formats, there are so many translation platforms, and final shipments are so many. If you look closely, then we are creating three copies of translations at three different places. First is your source repository, second is translation platform, and third is build system. And here you can see some mismatch condition being occurring. Like suppose you have pushed 100 strings to translation platform and added 5 more strings at source repository and building with 105 strings. But yet only 100 strings are getting translated. So 5 strings will remain untranslated because that they were not pushed to translation platform for translation. So there are so many mismatch conditions. And we concluded on these three points: is everything translated, packaged, and built? Second is, are all strings pushed to translation platform, latest to software repositories? And third is, how about release readiness? Now, let's look at the use cases to reduce this gap we had. And we come up with some use cases. First is everything translated, packaged? So in Transtats, we have two different features. First is package translation completeness, and second is translation coverage. So in package translation completeness, we are pulling translation statistics from these three places, upstream, platform, and downstream, and then we are generating diff to understand the gap on the basis of branch mapping, which is created for each and every package. I'll show what a branch mapping is. And second is translation coverage, which is for insights. So here you can see that package translation completeness, how it works. Once you will go to Transtats web portal, there you have one tab, packages. When you will select the packages, you'll land up to package list view. From that package list, you can select one of the package, say GNOME shell, and then you can actually go to GNOME shell's detailed view. Here you can see that we have translation statistics from upstream, from Damlize for three different versions, and from Koji build system, and we are generating diff. So in diff, we are listing some of the languages. in two different colors, red and blue. For the colors red, this means that there are some strings translated in translation platform, and we need to pull those strings and build the package. And those which are in blue, that means that they couldn't make 100% in Koji build system. So this is very particular to languages, like for language maintainers, or maybe, I mean, this is very much focused to package maintainers. They can easily see like which language is not 100% or which language is out of sync. Now let's look at translation coverage. Translation coverage is very interesting thing. Like here we can create rules, and for creating those rules, we can use this form. There are two important things, like in branch mapping, we are mapping build tag with all the releases. Like for Fedora 31, we'll be mapping it with F31 build tag. And so you can actually use those build tag, or you can override those build tags. And second is release. It will be more clear with the demo. So let's go to demo now. Here, this is the coverage rule page. You can create your own rule. For creating your rule, you need to log in into the system using your fast login. And once you log in, you can go and create a coverage rule. Here, you can just give the name of a rule, and you have to select a release from Fedora 31 or 30, whatsoever. Then here, you need to select tags. So you can actually override those branch mapping tags or go with them. So I'm going with them, so it will take F31. And now we can select packages. So we are selecting different packages like Ebert, Evolution, GNOME, Initial Setup, and Python May. And you can notice that Ebert, Python May are being translated at Zenata, whereas GNOME Initial Setup is being translated at Damlays. So this is very, varied kind of thing. Now we are selecting some languages in which the coverage will be generated. So we have selected four different languages, and we are making this rule as a public to be viewed for all. So this is the new rule test we have created. And in test, you can see that this is just side-by-side diff of translation platform and build system, whatsoever we have in translation platform and what has been built. And this statistic is coming from latest build of that particular package. For example, if you will consider Python May, then in translation platform side, statistics is coming from Zenata, whereas in build system, it is coming from build system. And for Japanese, in Zenata, 23 strings has been translated, whereas in build system, only 20 strings are being packaged. So 3 strings are missing. So this is what mismatch condition I was talking about. And you can easily detect that using this coverage rules once you will create that. Now let's go back to our slide and look at the different question altogether. Second was, are all strings pushed to translation platform latest to software repositories? So we have a job to detect string change, and there are three important things we need to actually handle. First is branch. For example, your repository has Fedora 31 specific branch, then you have to mention that branch here. And second is, you need to give the command to generate pod file. Like there could be, there are some examples where package have their own command for pod file generation. So you need to provide that here. And it is very rare, but some packages maintain different domain, so you need to override that domain as well. Let's go back and look at the demo for this. So in Transtats, you can just select jobs and select YML jobs. There we have three templates. We have to go with track string change template. And this is the YML I was talking about. You can just edit those lines whatsoever required, and then you can select package name, for example, about, and release name, for example, 31. So what actually it does, it generates pot file from the repository, source repository, and it pulls pot file from translation platform and then creates some diff. So here job is being running, and we got some differences, like some strings has been added in source repository which were not pushed to translation platform. So we'll go to details page, and there we can see. This is details page for string change diff. That was input YML. This is all output for each and every step you had in YML files. And these are the strings which are actually added in source repository, but not pushed to translation platform. So if you'll go with full diff, then you will have line by line diff of what strings has been added and what has not. So I'll be searching for one string at line number 1993. So here you can see that these strings has been added, which were not pushed to translation platform. Now let's move back to slide. And how about release readiness? So in Transtats, now flow has been much improved, and from territory view, the first is territory view. From territory view, we can select either language or releases. We can come down to packages, and from packages, we can go to jobs and coverage. So I'll show this. I mean, this is pretty interesting, like how things are currently is there. So this is landing page of Transtats. Here you can see one map. So this map is actually release readiness for Fedora 31 on entire map. And we can select any of the territory here. This map is only based on build packages statistics. So this map is not built on translation platform statistics. And once you will click on any of the territory, for example, Hungary, you can see differences in percentage for translation platform and build system. Then you can navigate to languages page. This is languages details page. You can see contact details of different language maintainers as well for different translation platforms. And here we'll be going in details of Fedora 31. So this is the per package view of any of the release where some translation is remaining. This is translation platform statistics. And from here we can go to any of the package, say Anaconda. So this is the page for Anaconda. It is pointing to Fedora Zenata. And this is branch mapping I was talking about. Translation platform, build system, and to release. So here we can see that for Dutch, Anaconda Fedora 31 has some difference. And for Dutch language, there are some strings in translation platform which needs to be pulled. From there, we can go to related jobs page. And these are the jobs which run for Anaconda. Now let's go to sync downstream job, which actually sync a package with build system, and go to details page. This is the analysis of statistics we received for build, which for this particular NVR built on this particular date. This is YML, and this is output of each and every step of that particular YML. So what it does, it actually goes and see for latest build details, download SRPM, apply all the patches. It actually reads and parse spec file and then does everything. And then finally extract translation files and calculate statistics. So this was actually the total view from start to end of Transtats. Now let's move back to slide. And I'll explain like what is the Transtats support currently. So we are supporting four translation platforms, Damlize, Transifex, Zenata, and Weblet. In file formats, we are just supporting one, PO, POMO, get text, build system, Fedora build system, and version control, we are supporting Git. So our next focus would be IT9 frameworks or file formats. So we'll be expanding in that zone. This is how Transtats work. Actually, there are jobs which pull all the statistics or all the translation resources from various different places, and we have a huge amount of translation database with us. We run analytics on them to generate statistics, meaningful data. So in layers, we have resources, jobs, presentation layer, interaction layer. So resources is basically inventory kind of thing where we need to manage each and everything and then run jobs on top of that and several other things. Interaction layer, we have APIs. We have, I think, more than 5 endpoints as of now. CLI, notification and integrations. So I'll invite Parag for a CLI demo and further continuation. Just wanted to show, in the meantime, Transtats is available at transtats.fedoraproject.org. So please go to that and have a look.
So I'm going to present about the CLI for this Transtats. So as you have seen that, whatever the Sandeep has talked is about the Transtats projects and its UI, how it looks into the web. But you know, basically this Transtats is used by upstream developers, package maintainers, and translators. So these are the three main people role who are going to use the Transtats. But there can be a need that they don't need to actually go into the web URL of the Transtats and they want to manage it from their command line only. So they can use the CLI thing, and that's why we have developed a Transtats CLI in Python. So if you want to use it, you can just install it like a DNF install Python 3 Transtats CLI, and you will get the Transtats command on your system. And this Transtats command can be helpful for you to use these different commands like coverage, job, package, release, and version. So I may demo you. So basically, after installing that package, you just need to run a command Transtats, and here is how it looks. So there are the 5 commands, and I can show you. So basically, if you want to check what version is available Transtats on your system, so you can check it, just say a Transtats version, it will tell you what client version is installed on your system. And if you want to check what server version is available, then just pass a argument like --- server, and it will communicate with the server and it will tell you that it's a 0.7.5 version. So that is one demo. And we have released the 0.3.0 client version of the Transtats, and in this release we have covered the enhancements that is done by Sandeep into the upstream project. This enhancements is related with the package command. So let's check with the package command. So if you just say a Transtats package --help, you will get to know that there are different options that you can use. You can override the server URL. You can check whether a package exists or not. So let's check. Let's check if ABRT1 is available on the server or not. It's not. So you will get a message like ABRT package not available on the Transtats server. Let's check with the ABRT package name. Yes, it exists. Then we can try some other options like just getting a package analysis. So we have used the auth config package, and so likewise there are different options that you can use. So even we can use a health command, health option. So here. If you just say package, it shows you that for which branch, it's a COGIF F30 branch. These are the languages, and on the right side, you will get the completion status. Okay. Then if you want to check with the health will give you the difference. So difference like what is the difference between the translation system and what is the difference between the build system, COGI build system. There are other commands like job command is there. So you can even submit a job from your command line to the Transtats server. So you can check, I mean, these are the different options you can use. You can sync the upstream source code with the translation system downstream, and you can even check for a string change. Okay. So suppose you want to run the job of a type sync upstream Anaconda for Fedora 31. So it will take some time to generate the URL. So here you can see that job has been created, log, and you will get the job ID. Okay, now you can use the log option to check whether that job log, what it shows, you can check that a job type is sync upstream. Okay, then it's for the Anaconda, and we have used the same job ID. So this is, I have a recorded demo, so I'm just running that. So you can see that the it has cloned the repository from the Anaconda, and it has generated a translation stats. So yeah, I mean, there are different commands and options are available in the Transtats CLI that you can utilize. So maybe I think I can wrap up for the time. Any questions?
Mm-hmm. And so what I noticed is that I'm supposed to basically give translations for modular packages to the end users.
Mm-hmm.
Right now it's only in English.
Okay.
So what I realized in the the portable object files is that, let's say if something has a spelling error,
mm-hmm.
Even that's translated, even though the translation would be correct because it's manually done. Mm-hmm. So there's an updated version and then there's the previous version. So why? So
see, if you are a package maintainer and if you are knowing that that is an error, then you can go ahead and remove that.
Why is the process manual?
For your project, it might be manual. Actually, it is very hybrid kind of situation where some upstream manage their push and pull thing automatically using their tools and everything. Actually, GitHub also has a plugin whereby you can push and pull, right? So it is very hybrid in nature where push and pull is up to the decision of the upstream, whatsoever they'll follow. So either you need to automate that or you need to use CLI and write a wrapper on that. So if you are using Zenata, use Zenata CLI, write a wrapper on Zenata CLI to push and pull. And if you need any help, then I can help you for that. So it is very platform specific kind of. See, internals of Zanata is like they store everything in database and they generate BFS on the fly. So actually you should go and edit in Zanata and then pull back. This is the correct method. But if you are in the end situation where you have to build it today and deliver, then you can go for edit kind of thing. Edit kind of thing, like manually edit and then push. But you should update that in Zanata too.
Yeah,
that has been updated. Yeah.
Exactly.
That's where Transtats came in picture. Any further question?
Transtats will provide information about activities. I mean, the maintainer has changed, updated, or something like that.
As of now, no. Because maintainer activity logs are not being pulled from translation platforms. Only statistics is being currently pulled. So we have that on our roadmap, but I mean, it is not in very near future.
Even the team activities would be fine.
Exactly. Right, exactly. So you have seen the languages detail page where we have contact information. So we have plans to enhance that page and get something very catchy. So this would be something which would be very catchy. If we have some logs running and some feeds would be occurring. So yeah, that we can do. Thank you for the suggestion, yeah.
Some sort of sorting also would be possible.
It is there, I think. On the package details, on the package list, yeah.
Here.
So just in case you have some suggestions, bugs or something, create an issue on GitHub. That is github/transtats is server repo. So create issue there and get in touch. So that. Do you have slides?
Yeah.
You can turn to last page. So we are available at Fedora 89 and Transtats channel, and docs are at docs.transtats. github/transtats is the repository URL. And one important thing, if you have some feedback, please drop that in feedback.transtats.xyz. Thank you.
Thank you.